Welcome to the special joint session of the Brockton School Committee and the Brockton City Council. Would you join me in saluting the flag? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I want to thank everybody for being here. Mr. Clerk, would you read the order?
We have the call of the meeting. In accordance with Section 36 of the City Charter, the City Council and the School Committee shall meet in a joint convention to serve out the balance, to elect and serve out the balance of the unexpired term of Wayne McCallister on the Southeastern Regional School Committee.
Accepted and placed on file.
We have the officer's return of notice.
Accepted and placed on file.
In any related matters.
Councilors of the School Committee, first of all, I want to thank you for being here tonight, and I want to welcome the School Committee members and as Chairman of the School Committee, Mayor Carpenter, for being here this evening. It's certainly a sad evening. Wayne McCallister was a great Brocktonian. Besides his service on the Southeastern Regional Vocational Technical District School Board, Wayne was a long time member of the Brockton Planning Board and a long time member of the chairman of the Brockton Planning Board, and did wonderful work and is what we all as public servants strive for, to do it for all the right reasons. And Wayne did, and he did it for a long time. And I'd like to start with a moment of silence for Mr. McCallister. Thank you. Just to let you know how this will work this evening, it's a little bit different, but the process will be the same as when the late Mr. Healy passed on and we had to elect a replacement in Ward 6. However, it is governed under the Southeastern Regional School District Agreement, not our city ordinances, but we will, we have put the word out, and we have four people who have expressed an interest. I will entertain nominations for each person, because they will need to be nominated to be considered. We're then going to give each candidate 3 minutes to speak. I've decided we'll do that alphabetically after we've taken the nominations. And after each candidate has spoken, you will have an opportunity to ask questions of those candidates if you have questions, any member of the convention, which is what we will be referred to tonight, is the convention to do this. So at this point, I would entertain nominations.
Mr. President.
Councilor Razak.
I'd like to nominate Tony Branch for Southeastern Regional School Committee seat.
Second.
Motion is made and seconded to nominate Tony Branch for the Southeastern Regional School seat. Councilor Farwell.
Mr. President, I'd like to nominate Gerson Montero as a replacement for Mr. McCallister.
Do I have a second? Motion made and seconded for Gerson Montero. Councilor Monahan.
Yes, Mr. President, I'd like to nominate Gwendolyn Barnes.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Motion made and seconded to nominate Gwendolyn Barnes. Councilor Rodriguez.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to nominate Stephen Abrams as a replacement for the late Wayne McCallister.
Second.
Motion made and seconded to nominate Stephen Abrams. So at this time.
Mr. President, I'm going to close nominations.
Second.
Second.
Motion made and seconded to close nominations. All those in favor? All those opposed? Nominations are now closed. So at this point, going alphabetically, I believe Mr. Stephen Abrams, if you're here tonight, could you please step up to the rostrum and introduce yourself.
Do we have an ambulance?
Yeah.
I hurt my wife's knee, so that's not going to go well.
Well, that's one vote you won't get.
That's right. Well, I just want to thank everybody for meeting tonight. As you know, my name is Steve Abrams. Just want to stand before you to let you know my intentions on why I want to serve. You know all about me. You have my resume. You have my credentials. You know the work that I've done in this city. I don't want to stand here tonight to talk about me, my 30 years of government service. I served overseas, so I desire to serve at home now. And that's one of my main intentions on seeking this distinguished seat. I just want to talk about the ones that I'll be serving for, the children. I was invited to the Southeast Regional Vocational High School open house. And when I walked through those halls, I was amazed. One of the parents invited me because they know the work that I do here and that I've done in the city for many years. So I was amazed what I seen and I heard in their voices that they was concerned about their treasure. They was concerned about their treasure for higher learning, for higher education. And that's what they desire, for their treasure to move forward. And I was excited about that. It took me back from my times when I was a Downey PTA member, when this distinguished gentleman from Ward 3 was a school committee member there. And they had to allocate $90 million for 6 new schools. And being on that PTA as a member, he took me through the matrix and he let me know why do we need $90 million for those new schools. And I was excited as a young man, had a lot of hair back then, and I was excited that my kids would have an opportunity to travel across the bridge of higher education. And I began the process, and I heard the parents at Southeast Regional, they wanted those same desires for their kids. And I said, why not? Why can't their kids travel the same bridge that my kids crossed? They had an opportunity to go to college, graduated from Brockton High, Abigail Adam alumni, and they desire to come back and work in the city. That's our treasure, that our kids come back to work in the city. And that's why we will grow, and that's why we are the City of Champion. And I was really impressed by how I was taken in and showed how the city operates through that my experience there at the Downey as a PTA member, also the work that I've done in this city. So that school embodies education with a purpose. It's not just a school for vocational tech rehabilitation, it's a school for parents, students, and faculty to stay with the students from beginning to end. This is not a springboard to do something else. This is a springboard to bring our treasures back to the city of Brockton. Mr. McCallister served with professional integrity. That integrity must be maintained at any cost. Being a part of the veteran alumni, we follow orders to a fault. And I'm very honored to have one of my senior veteran alumni here with me tonight, Mr. Scott Vecchi, always pushing about education and innovative ideas to have education with a purpose. I went throughout the county and I heard about Brockton, Halifax, Duxbury, Plymouth. People was telling me, I'm from Brockton. I went to Brockton High. And I heard that same voice. Their treasure was really held in high esteem. So that's why I want to stand here and serve tonight, because I served over there. I desired to serve at home. I don't know, was that a clock?
It was me dropping my clock.
Okay.
You're just about done, though.
We're here to make a difference. We're here to make a difference, the difference of hope. As I said before, maintain this professional integrity that Mr. McCallister would have desired for his legacy to go on, to do the good work, to help one family. I went through the shops and the showcases. Because I'm a steel worker, Local 7, I went to the steel shop, and this is the things that the children were making. Now, you can't teach, you're not born with this gift. This gift is taught. And it's held with you for the rest of your life. They use the plasma arc cutter, submerged arc cutter. They use heli arc. These young people was cutting with a gas torch, and they made these things. And I was very impressed because some of the alumni students came back and to the open house, and they begin to tell their teachers the great things that they've done. That's why I want to serve. I want to begin to tell the parents the great things that their children can do. My kids crossed the bridge. Why can't your kids cross the bridge? We're not here to burn the bridge on both ends. Some would be flamethrowers and desire to leave the kids in the middle. But I'm here tonight to tell you, as a veteran alumni, we follow orders to a fault. If this is my path, this is my path. My desires and my aspirations are to serve.
You can finish up, please.
So in my closing, just want to say thank you again. Thank you for having this time. Because I served over there, I desire to serve at home. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Abrams. We will now have Gwendolyn Barnes. Good evening.
Good evening. Good evening, everyone, especially the council. I prepared a written statement for you. I won't be before you long, and I think I'll have under 3 minutes, but it'll be near there. Good evening again, everyone. My name is Gwendolyn Barnes, and I want to thank you all for considering me to fill the recent vacancy on the Southeastern Regional Vocational Technical High School School Committee. I practiced that. I am a retired educator from the Boston Public Schools, having taught in 5 school systems, totaling 49 years, over 49 years of service to children, including 10 years in the Washington, D.C. public schools system. I was born, raised, and educated in Brockton, where I currently live. I recently visited the campus of Southeastern, and I must say I was greatly, greatly impressed with everything I saw, especially the development of the school's curriculum. I visited the cafeteria, the auto mechanic department, carpentry, the little houses, of which I adored, the culinary arts and cosmetology programs, the electrical department, theater arts, the academic programs, just to name a few of its programs. Although my exposure to a vocational curriculum has been limited in the past, I am excited about the possibilities and the opportunities to learn so much more about it through my participation as a member of the school committee. A large percentage of the Southeastern regional students are from Brockton, and I find that very encouraging. I have been active in my community through such organizations as BDN, which is the Brockton Day Nursery After School Tutorial Programs, grades 1 through 6, the COA, which is the Council on Aging, of which I am a member, many church ministries at my church, Mount Moriah Baptist Church, as a diaconate member and teacher of biblical history classes, which I teach every week, as well as other community volunteer programs. I'm confident that my extensive experiences in education, my working knowledge of education policies, and my passion for young people makes me the most qualified candidate to be the second Brockton representative on the Southeastern Regional Vocational Technical High School School Committee this academic school year, 2016-2017. On Tuesday, November 15th, I was fortunate enough to have attended a scheduled school meeting at the Armstead Conference Room in Southeastern. Mr. Mark Linda was nominated and won the position of the new school committee chairperson. Kudos to Mark. Kudos. On Saturday, November 19th, again I visited the open house event held at the school. As I explored the many areas and classes within the school, I realized how vast and extensive the learning possibilities are, from the day programs to the evening programs, to the continuing education programs for students and adults alike. And sometimes as I was walking the halls, I think I missed the halls of academia more than I realized I did that day. I was especially interested and impressed with the little houses and the cookies that Superintendent Lopes baked, and they were very good. At this time, I have no future political aspirations in regards to this position on the school committee. Going forward, I just strongly believe that I am the best candidate to fill this vacancy. Thank you, councilors, for the opportunity to come before you for consideration in this matter. Thank you for listening to me, and everyone have a great evening. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. And if anybody's timing at home, they know that that was 4:20 and Mr. Abrams was 4:30, so the other candidates will have that long too. My 3 minutes run to 4.5 minutes. Well, now, who is our third? Miss Tony Branch, please. Good evening.
Good evening, fine people. I'm not a very good public speaker, so I hope that you guys bear with me. Hold on for a moment. I want to thank the Brockton City Council, the school committee, and the members of Wayne McCallister's family for being here today. I do have prepared statements, but I'm going to talk to you all like your family. And the reason why I'm going to do that, because we are family in this city. The fact remains that today is not a good day. This is a day that we're talking about filling this particular role, but we have lost not only a father to this community, but a father to this family and a son of the city of Brockton. So it's a bit, you know, upsetting to be here. I'm comforted today by the citizens of the city of Brockton that have applied for this role. It is comforting to me to know that there are qualified people that are not like me. So I present to you a question. Maybe Tony Branch is the wrong choice for this role. The wrong choice. Unless you're looking for someone with 30 years of activism, I may be the wrong choice. Unless you're looking for someone who has real life experiences with young adults. As a person that was a teen, a homeless, in the city of Boston during my teen years, I connect with young people. The reason why I connect with young people is because I understand the daily trauma that they experience. So they're not bad kids when they come to school needing discipline. These are children that have suffered some pain. I connect with that experience. But in addition to that daily trauma, the reason why I appreciate public education, because it was Patricia O'Brien at the Marymount School of Science and Technology. But when I went to my high school, she made sure that I ate. When I went to my high school and had to talk about some of my daily traumas, she made sure that she was an ear for me to hear. This is activism. I may be the wrong choice if you're not looking for someone, I may be the wrong choice if you're not looking for someone who has worked on food insecurity in the Commonwealth. I've worked on a food pantry as an executive director, and I've worked on regulations and legislation that deal with food feeding, not only giving you food, but also giving meals to homeless families. And why do I bring that up? I bring that up because I know that when a student comes to school and they have been fed, and no matter what they have experienced in their life, they recognize and realize that they have something that is off their list, something that they can put aside so that they're able to accomplish in their academics. I may be the wrong choice unless you're looking for someone who's been on the front line of social justice in Brockton, fighting for a living wage for every Brocktonian, fighting for raise up so that we'll have additional money for schools, education, and transportation. I may be the wrong choice unless you're looking for someone who has a moral compass, where the needs of the community come first. What does that mean? That goes beyond just prayer. That means that I'm dying for mothers and fathers where their parents need to be wiped away. So I may be the wrong choice unless you're looking for that sort of activism. In 2015, voters in Ward 4, 227 people said that I was on the right track. 2016, 3,027 voters in the Plymouth Bristol district believed that I was on the right track. So the community knows me. But prior to this hour, I made no calls to any of you seeking your support. But at 11:56 this morning, when I received the last call for people to go for this nomination, I ran to City Hall to put in my nomination because the people know my track record. So at this hour, this is not about passing the torch. Not about that at all. But it's about having the right candidate, the right person in that seat that keeps the torch lit. God bless you, and do me one other favor. Say something nice about Brockton. God bless you.
Thank you very much, Bishop. And our fourth candidate is Gerson Montero. Good evening.
Good evening, dear councilpersons and school committee members. Again, my name is Gerson Montero. Born in Cape Verde, but raised in Brockton, so every time everyone asks me, I always say I'm a Brocktonian. I am invested in the education of our youth, a product of Brockton Public School Systems. I'm a teacher in the Brockton Public School Systems. I've worked in the middle school and also currently at the high school. And I've been doing that for the past 7 years. And I know that today, public education, it's a very important time today for public education. It's filled with tough, demanding challenges, and I will do my best, if appointed to this position, to tackle these challenges in a way that would be beneficial to our students and our staff and the staff and also the school. I believe that in addition to meeting the minimum requirements to hold the position, I feel I can bring many other valuable attributes to the position. I feel I can bring attributes such as being a leader, a team player, effective communicator, consensus builder, decision builder, and organizer. And all this is from my time, from what I learned from my teachers as well at Brockton High. For example, Mr. Udo in my U.S. history classes, Mr. O'Brien when I wanted to play soccer rather than hit my books, and my English teacher, and he sat down and talked to me and said, hey, yeah, soccer might get you somewhere, but when you break your leg or something happens You know, what I'm teaching you is going to get you through that. Working at the church and also working with the youth here in Brockton, we put together a soccer team that brings youth from my church and from the outside, and we play at Pick Park every Sunday to try to give a better example for the youth. I've also have experience working when it comes to working with the union. I used to be a field rep for SEIU 888, and I negotiated contracts. So I bring all that package with me. So again, if I'm appointed to this position, I will work with the other committee members to create a shared vision for work and learning, build strategic partnerships, sustain the school progress through continuous improvement, and maintain a strong ethical standards that already is already there, and objectively seek answers to questions and challenges as they arise. So again, in closing, I'll say thank you for the opportunity, and thank you for the time, and thank you for the nomination. And I hope you guys choose who's best for our students and for our kids that are represented at Southeastern. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Councilors, conventionally, as I should say, before we get to any questions, I had been contacted on, and I think it's a great idea, the chairman of the Southeastern Regional School Committee, Mark Lindy, would like to say a few words to us and maybe fill us in a little bit on the school. And when we do get to questions, if anybody has specific school questions, Mr. Lopes and Mr. Wheeler, the principal and the superintendent of the regional school, are here too. So Mr. Lindy, could you come forward and speak to us for a minute? Not going to time you, but up here I am.
Okay. Well, I'm used to talking for TV. Thank you for the opportunity to be here, and I'm very pleased that we have four very qualified candidates for Wayne's seat. It is sad to be here tonight, and I just want to thank his daughter Sarah and his sister Deborah, who are here in the audience, for sharing him with the Brockton community. He was a wonderful mentor and a wonderful friend. One thing that I know Wayne would like to see is somebody that serves in the position and stays in the position. It's a two-year term. You folks have a great choice in front of you. The two-year term, I would hate to see a year from now someone running for another office. That's a personal opinion, but I know it's one that Wayne and I discussed in great detail. Wayne was a humble person. Wayne was a public servant. Wayne was somebody that first and foremost cared about the kids and never, ever, ever worried about accolades or anything for himself. I had the privilege of nominating him last month to be the Lifetime Achievement Award for the Mass Association of School Committees, and he would have killed me if he were alive to do that, but he deserved that award. Wayne served as the planning board chairman, as you know, and Wayne sat at the meeting, didn't say a lot, but when he did, it spoke volumes. We just heard from four, like I said, very qualified candidates. You folks have a tough choice. I've served for 8 years. I just got reelected, and it's a great school. We have great kids. 62% of them are from Brockton. It's top-rated, level one school, academically. All of the services are there for everybody to take part of, and we're very proud that Brockton is kind of the flagship of the whole system. So I wish you Godspeed tonight, and I appreciate you giving me the time to address the committee. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Mr. Lindy.
Mr. President, can I ask Mr. Lindy a question?
You may.
Mr. Good evening, Mr. Lindy. Is there a difference between what the Brockton School Committee has to do as a member there and at Southeastern Regional? Is there any...
Under the Education Reform Act of 1993, school committees set policy and budgets. The professional staff of the school runs the district. We are there for advice and to be ambassadors in the community, the same way the Brockton School Committee is. The Brockton School Committee has a lot of subcommittee meetings. They meet quite often. We do have subcommittees. We don't meet as often. We meet once a month, usually twice a month during budget season. We have a retreat during the summer to plan things. But the role of the school committees are essentially the same.
Are you involved in negotiations with the unions?
We are. We have, and Wayne was the chairman of the negotiation subcommittee, and he did an outstanding job in some troubling times and some good times. So yes, we do have we have American Federation of Teachers, and we do have a union.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Lee. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And I'd like to take a moment, if Wayne's daughter and sister could stand up, we'd like to, we appreciate you being here this evening. Councilors, as we get into questions, I will just inform you, when we get to a vote, the vote will be, the person to win will need a majority. In this case, that's going to be 10 votes. So somebody will need 10 votes. Okay. If after the first round of votes, nobody has a majority, the top two vote getters will move on, top two and ties, will move on to a second vote. So they will need a majority, 50% plus one, which in this case is 10 votes of this board. So at this time, if anybody has questions, and you school committee people aren't used to it, but I'm going to allow the councilors to stay seated while they're asking questions for this meeting. So anybody that has a question, you don't have to stand.
Just as a point of information, would you explain why Mr. Lindy isn't participating? Because some people may not be aware of the district compact and why he isn't up here voting with us.
Actually, and it was surprising at the time when it came about, but the rules for replacing someone are part of, as I said, the Southeastern Regional School District Agreement. And in that agreement, it falls, much as it did for the Brockton School Committee member that had to be replaced, to a convention, to a joint meeting of the School Committee and the City Council of Brockton. And it does not allow for, surprisingly myself, it does not allow for the Regional School Board to take part in that themselves. So. If I had written that, they would be doing that, but that's why they're not taking part. He's not taking part this evening.
Thank you, Mr.
But
Chairman.
But that's why I did want to give him time to speak, because certainly whoever gets this, and it is very heartening that we have four such qualified candidates here tonight. I'm very glad about that. But Mr. Lindy is one that will have to serve with whoever it is. So I did want to give him a moment to speak, and. Toot the horn of a great school over there that so many Brockton kids are attending. So, and at this point, whoever has questions for any particular candidate, I'll entertain, just raise your hand. And anybody have any questions? If not, we can move to a vote. Mr. D'Agostino.
The biggest question I have, and actually Mr. Lindy raised it when he was speaking, is it's a two-year appointment. And then what? And I don't know if how that would work for either.
You can. I would say you can ask each candidate to come up and
okay.
Answer that question.
So I'd like to hear from each candidate.
Mr. Abrams, don't kick your wife as you come through. But so your question specifically.
So specifically, you'll be appointed for 2 years, and at the end of 2 years, that's it. Continue on. Run for re-election. What's your longer-term plan for this position?
Thank you for the question. My intention is to do a good enough job that when they see my name on the ballot again, they would vote me in, the constituents, proving that I'm a true leader and would be the best person for this position. So my answer to the question is I want to go further in the seat.
Okay, thank you.
I assume you'd like to hear the same question from Ms. Barnes?
Absolutely, please.
If you could.
Well, since it's obvious that I'm not a politician, I have no political aspirations, I would like to serve with distinction, as I have done over 49 years, in what I know. This is what I know. I know education. I know what to do regarding education. I'm always interested in it. This is all I know. So hopefully, you know, if I'm chosen tonight, I will serve with distinction and serve it well. After that, hopefully, I will continue. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Same question of Mr. Branch.
Thank you for who asked the question? I apologize.
I
thank you so much for the question.
By the way, for the public at home, that's Ward 3 School Committee person, Mr. D'Agostino. My error.
Thank you for the question. I would serve and run for re-election, and the flip side of that, not to influence any votes, but I've already, look at my record in terms of getting votes. I've already kind of have a history around getting votes countywide. So if that's helpful to anyone. Thank you very much for the question.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And Mr. Montero.
I'll do my best to run to serve with distinction, and if chosen by the people, definitely would like to run again and serve the full term of 4 years, and then see what happens after that.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. D'Agostino, any other questions?
No, sir.
Thank you. Mr. Minicello, do you have a question?
I'm going to ask the same question.
Thank you. Any other questions? Councilor Monahan.
Yes, this is to all of them. Have any of them had, I think I said Mr. Montero might have had some dealings with as far as contract negotiations. Has anybody dealt in with that, with unions in the contract negotiations?
Yes, dealing with the contract negotiation. I'm a retired Teamster, Local 25. We had major contracts nationally. I sat in as a steward, also as a chief steward in most of those negotiations.
Very good. Thank you.
Okay, go ahead, and then we'll get Ms. Barnes. No, go ahead. You're already up. It's okay.
I'm sorry. I've had extensive experience with contract negotiations with respect. I think the real question is with respect to labor relations. Absolutely. Not only as the Vice President of Administrative Services, but as a Director of Operations for several hospitals across the Commonwealth. In addition to that, I've been on the other side of this, whereas I've represented employees as a paralegal before labor relations, MCAD, and EEOC. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ms. Barnes.
Yes. My experience is very
Please step forward just so the people at home can hear you.
I have to admit, I've not had very much experience with contract. I mostly taught in the public schools and tutored and like that, but I have served as union representative in some situations where I've had to do other things other than actual teaching, but I've not had that much experience in contract.
Thank you.
Thank you.
As I stated earlier, I do have some experience in that. I was the SEIU rep for the 495 alt corridor for SEIU Local 888. I had about 2,000 members that I had to look after, and I had to negotiate the contracts anywhere. It was from City Hall in Boston all the way to the borders of New York State.
Okay, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. Any other questions?
Easier.
Before we move to Councilor Azar.
I don't have a question, but I do have a statement. I want to personally thank the four candidates. It is really hard to put yourself out there, and as a Brocktonian, we really are lucky in Brockton. There are some cities and towns that can't get anybody to run for these offices, and we are lucky. So thank you very much for, you're all qualified, you're all amazing people, so thank you for putting your hat in.
Thank you. Before we move to a vote, I just want to say, even though I'm running this meeting, I want to thank Mayor Carpenter, the chairman of the school committee, and the vice chairman, Tom Minicello, because the work wasn't all tonight for this meeting. There was quite a bit of work trying to figure out what the statutes were and to organize a group like these two groups is like herding cats. So I want to thank Mr. Minicello and Your Honor, and I want to thank our council, Mr. Gilday, and City Clerk Mr. Zioli. And we'll be reading your name alphabetically and state what candidate you want, and then Mr. Gilday will give us a tally. Please read the roll.
Joyce Azak.
Tony Branch.
Shirley Azak.
Tony Branch.
Beauregard.
Steve Abrams.
Carpenter.
Tony Branch.
Cruz.
Steve Abrams.
D'Agostino.
Steve Abrams.
Ioneary.
Mr. Montero.
Farwell.
Mr. Montero.
Gormley.
Barnes.
Lally.
Barnes.
Minicello.
Mr. Abrams.
Monahan.
Tony Branch.
Plant.
Gerson Montero.
Rodriguez.
Abrams.
Studinski.
Tony Branch.
Judy Sullivan.
Stephen Abrams.
Robert Sullivan.
Tony Branch.
Timothy Sullivan.
Tony Branch.
Six for Abrams, two for Barnes, seven for Branch, and three for Montero.
So we will move on to a second vote with Mr. Abrams and Mr. Branch. Let me give you a second to prepare. You all set? Mr. Clerk, please call the roll.
Joyce Azak.
Tony Branch.
Shirley Azak.
Tony Branch.
Beauregard.
Steve Abrams.
Carpenter.
Branch.
Cruz.
Abrams.
D'Agostino.
Abrams.
Ioneary.
Abrams.
Farwell.
Abrams.
Gormley.
Branch.
Lally.
Branch.
Minicello.
Mr. Abrams.
Monahan.
Branch.
Plant.
Abrams.
Rodriguez.
Abrams.
Studinski.
Branch.
Judy Sullivan.
Stephen Abrams.
Robert Sullivan.
Tony Branch.
Timothy Sullivan.
Tony Branch.
Nine for each candidate.
Oh my God.
Nine for each candidate.
Oh my God.
Flip a coin. They're both.
Anybody have any other questions they'd like to ask, or we can move on to another vote? Councilor Farwell.
Yes, given the fact it's a tied vote, I'd just like to ask Mr. Abrams and Mr. Branch, what would be your first priority if you were selected for this position?
Mr. Abrams, you want to step up and...
Could you repeat the question?
Yes, if you're selected, what would be your first priority as an incoming member of the Southeastern Regional School District?
All right, my first priority would be to sit down and talk to the senior school committee member and find out all the intricate details about the position, how does the system work, and what's my best approach to serving as a distinguished school committee member. Also, how does the parents interact with the school committee to further their children's education? How can we speak to the parents about their treasure? That would be my first. And also following the distinguished service that has gone on before and maintain that integrity. That's the number one thing, is the utmost integrity that Mr. McCallister embodied about this position. This is not a springboard. It's not a sounding board. It's a position of integrity to stay with the children from the elementary to high school to further their careers, and hopefully our treasures come back, and I want to be one of those beacons to allow that to happen, a bridge. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Branch, what would be your first priority as an incoming member of the committee if you're selected tonight?
I have no priorities. The priorities is the will of the community, and the will of the community suggests is that there are two answers to this. From an administrative standpoint, a person that goes to any position, especially in leadership, they need to look at the prior minutes. They need to talk about the folks that are already on the school committee. I would actually defer to Mark Lindy. I would meet with him to discuss what is actually happening in the regional system. And then the second piece of that, which is the most important piece of it, is what is the community asking for? And the community is asking for a connection, whether it's the regional system or whether it's public education and the Brockton School Committee. They're asking for a connection to what is happening with their children. So I would reach out to try to figure out how to broaden communications in that regard. But again, folks, this is really not me. It's the will of the people that are going to be electing this position in 2018.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
You all set, Councilor Farwell?
Yes, thank
Councilor
you.
Councilor Azak.
Thank you, Mr. President. This question actually is for Mr. Abrams. How long have you been in the city of Brockton?
I've been in the city of Brockton since 1990.
And this is, you've never actually ran for an elected office. Have you run for a school committee or
Absolutely
a previous
not.
Office?
No political experience.
So what made you decide that you wanted this?
The will
position?
Of the parents. I heard so many parents echoing the same thing that I've echoed raising my children in this city, that their treasurer wants to be further in education. So I heard the will of the parents. I heard the community church that I belong to, how their kids are feeling somewhat left behind because there are those that would desire to burn the bridge on both ends. Like I said, I'm a bridge builder. I'm a veteran. I follow orders to a fault. I've served, led men into hostile and imminent danger. So because I served out of this city, they took me in as a Brocktonian many years ago.
Thank you, Mr. Abrams. Now the question, just a quick question follow up with that. Earlier, Mr. D'Agostino asked the candidates questions about running again, but I would like to be more specific. Would you run again to fill the same seat? Would you run in the next election for this seat?
Yeah, I don't see any reason not to.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. Now, I think a follow-up question would be just for Mr. Branch. I know that, even though I know he's already run, but give him a moment to tell us.
What, I'm sorry, Councilor, what was the question?
My question was, I know Mr. Abrams hadn't run in an election previously, but if you can tell us that, I believe in your statement, you did state that you ran for a school committee right. position.
So I ran for school committee because public education is under attack. And I ran because when I spoke to parents and students, they said that they wanted, and I'll be really straight about this, minority representation on the school committee for someone to bring our community values to the school body. That's why I was running. In addition to that, with respect to how long I've been in Brockton, I think I moved here in 1989. So I've been here for a very long time. Not necessarily politically active, but still active as an activist. And I think where, you know, we get a disconnect is that activism is about what benefits the folks here, what benefits the community, not political office. So I've been in the trenches because I was a part of those trenches, and that's where I'm interested in remaining in that particular spectrum. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Councilor Sullivan.
Thank you, Mr. President. I have a question for both gentlemen, Mr. Abrams and Mr. Branch. Mr. Lindy, who's served very, very well the school committee for many, many years, indicated that 62% of the student population come from the city of Champions, the city of Brockton. That means another 38% come from other municipalities. My question is this, even though if you are fortunate enough to becoming a member of the school committee, serving Southeastern Regional and serving Mr. Lindy, how do you, as a member of that board, get what measures do you undertake to get an understanding of the needs and desires of the students and parents from those other municipalities, because it's not just a Brockton seat, and there is 38% other student population. What would you do to get, a real understanding and need and desires for those individuals as well?
That's the excellent question, Mr. Sullivan. One thing, I'm a firm believer that it takes a village to raise a child. So whether those children are from Southeastern, Abington, Whitman, Halifax, East Brockton, it takes all of us to raise that child to be the treasure that the parents desire for them to be. It's not about me, it's about the whole. So therefore, to connect that same concept of taking a village, it takes all of us. It takes that school district, our school districts, everyone to raise that children to be a quality role model. And hopefully they will come back and serve their community well.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Branch, same question to you, sir.
Fairly quickly. No different than our city council and our school committee that represents different parts of this city. I would go to my colleagues that are currently on the regional system. What type of challenges are the parents talking to you about? Can I attend meetings with you in order to have a discussion, in order for me to do some mining of that data? So it's basically reaching out to the folks that are already a part of the regional system and figuring out how to best communicate with those particular constituencies. I hope that makes some sense.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Councilor. School Committeeman Sullivan, Tim Sullivan.
Yes. Can you hear me out there?
Recently in Brockton, a new charter school has come to Brockton, the New Heights. Each one, could I have your feelings on charter schools, on that particular one, and other ones coming to Brockton, if any? What's your feeling on that?
So you all, the good thing about me, you kind of know what my position is. Additional charter schools, and I'm a part of the statewide campaign, I have expertise in this. Additional charter schools in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts are not needed. Specifically to the charter school that came to Brockton to steal from our students, to steal from our funding, it should not be here. If I could chain myself to the building that they're going to be going into or whatever they're doing right now, I would do that just to show some opposition. So I'm strongly opposed to the charter school that has joined us in this particular city. Thank you.
Thank you. That's an excellent question. I listen to both sides of the charter school argument. Everyone has a valid voice. Everyone has a serious concern. And I think those concerns need to be peeled back. And I think we need to drill down and find out exactly the best way to help our students advance. Like I said, it's not about me. It's not about your idea, my idea. What's the best idea? Everyone on that side of the argument, the state of Massachusetts shot it down, fine. But the people that are for it, they have legitimate concerns. Common sense education, education with a purpose. I don't stand here and say, boom, that's it. No, there's some flexibility. Everyone that has a battle focus, that has an overall intent of our commander-in-chief. So the overall intent of our commander-in-chief is to make Brockton kids first.
Mr. D'Agostino, this will be the last question. We're going to take a vote after this, and if it doesn't change, councilors and body members, just to let you know, if the vote next vote doesn't change, we're going to have to recess and gavel in the city council meeting, which was scheduled for 8 o'clock. So, Mr. D'Agostino, you have a question?
Yes, for both candidates. I take this a little bit personally as a member of the Southeastern Regional Class of 1997. So, knowing that I'm an alumni of the school, what is the most important thing that you want me to know about you as an alumni having a vote on this?
Excellent question. One of the most important things that I'm a father, father first, walked the halls of education, seeing the kids come back to do great things in the city of Brockton. And I would hope all the kids would have that same experience as you have had to aspire to the esteemed position that you have hold right now. My number one concern that I want you to know about me, I follow orders to a fault. Whatever the mission is, that's the mission for the whole. And I would hope everyone would have that whole concept. But as we know in life, nothing's perfect. So mm-hmm. I am a person, a father, a husband, a man of faith. And I believe in the city of Champion who adopted me and took me in. This city has done so much for me and my family that it's time for me to give back. Thank you.
Same question for Mr. Branch.
I would want you to know, sir, that you're just as important as a person that's gone for a four-year degree. You're just as important as somebody going for a master's degree, a PhD. The disconnect in this country, and I'm going to say this, is that we've gotten to a point where hard work and greasy hands has become unknown. Hard work and vocational education is essential to the survival of this country. So I wanted to thank you not only for attending the school, but becoming the success that you are. That's what I would want you to know. Thank you.
Thank you. I'm going to call for a vote now. Ms. Clerk, can you please read the roll?
Joyce Azad.
Tony Branch.
Shirley Azad.
Tony Branch.
Beauregard.
Steve Abrams.
Carpenter.
Branch.
Cruz.
Abrams.
D'Agostino.
Branch.
Ioneary.
Mr. Abrams.
Farwell.
Mr. Abrams.
Gormley.
Mr. Abrams.
Lally.
Mr. Branch.
Minicello.
Mr. Abrams.
Monahan.
Branch.
Plant.
Abrams.
Rodriguez.
Abrams.
Studinski.
Branch.
Judy Sullivan.
Mr. Abrams.
Robert Sullivan.
Mr. Branch.
Timothy Sullivan.
Tony Branch.
Same thing.
Both candidates received 9 votes.
We're still deadlocked. At this time, do I have to ask the school to step out, or should I just call recess? All right, we're going to take a brief recess from this meeting because we need to gavel in the other meeting. So we're in recess right now. Scheduled meeting of the Brockton City Council for November 28th, 2016. However, I am now that we are in session, I'm going to move to a recess. Welcome back to the special joint session of the Brockton School Committee and the Brockton City Council. For the people at home and the people in the audience, just to let you know what we just did, tonight's regularly scheduled City Council meeting is set by ordinance. So because it's an ordinance meeting, we had to call it to order. We have now recessed that and come back into session as the joint committee. And I will now, first of all, I'd like to say that I think the fact that we've gone through several tie votes just speaks to the quality of the four people who are putting their names forward tonight, and I appreciate all the work of this body to take this so seriously, and of all four people, and particularly the final two for where we are at this point. And at this point, I'm going to ask the clerk to call the roll.
Joyce Azak.
Tony Branch.
Shirley Azak.
Tony Branch.
Beauregard.
Steve Abrams.
Carpenter.
Branch.
Cruz.
Abrams.
D'Agostino.
Branch.
Ioneary.
Branch, excuse me, Abrams.
Farwell.
Abrams.
Gormley.
Abrams.
Lally.
Branch.
Minicello.
Mr. Abrams.
Monahan.
Branch.
Plant.
Branch.
Rodriguez.
Abrams.
Studinski.
Branch.
Judy Sullivan.
Mr. Abrams.
Robert Sullivan.
Mr. Branch.
Timothy Sullivan.
Tony Branch.
Tie.
Yeah, I did. Tied again.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I broke it down. The top is school condition.
8 votes for Abrams, 10 votes for Branch.
Yeah. Did I miss two?
Congratulations, Mr. Branch. You are the new... And at this point, Mr. Branch, you can, in the next day or so, talk to the city clerk about getting sworn in, and Mr. Lindy about their schedule of meetings. At this point, does anybody have anything to add? We're adjourned. Thank you all very much, particularly the vice chairman and the chairman of the school committee. Thank you. Call this council meeting back to session.
Okay.
Mr. Clerk, item number one.
The acceptance of the minutes of November 14, 2016.
Accepted and placed on file.
Petition of Gary Thompson, DBA, ETA Automotive Repairs for Motor Vehicle Repair Mechanical License, located at 287 North Montello Street, Unit 3, Brockton.
Is Mr. Thompson here? Seeing that you're here tonight, I'll call this hearing to order. Is there anyone here in favor of this license? Please step forward to the microphone and just state your name for the clerk.
This is going to public safety. My name is Gary Augustus Thompson, and I'm the future owner of ETA Auto. I actually went to UTI, Universal Technical Institute, and I made the dean's list, so I think I should pay back to Brockton some way, somehow. And this is my way of contributing to the greater Brockton.
Thank you.
Thank you. Your
councilors, just so you know, the parking plan has been submitted. The clerk has it in his hands. Any questions, councilors? Is there anyone else here in favor of this license? Seeing none, I declare that portion of the hearing closed. Is there anyone here in opposition? If so, please step forward and give your name to the clerk. Seeing none, I declare that portion of the hearing closed. Question comes on granting the license. All those in favor? All those opposed, license is granted. Thank you very much. Good luck.
Thanks, sir.
Item number three.
Report of the Audience Committee of its meeting November 15, 2016.
Accepted and placed on file.
Report of the Finance Committee for its meeting of November 21, 2016.
Accepted and placed on file. I'd entertain a motion that we take items 5 through 8 collectively.
Make a motion we take numbers 5 through 8 collectively.
Second.
Motion made and seconded to take 5 through 8 collectively. All those in favor? All those opposed? Mr. Clerk, please read items 5 through 8.
Solid Air Care Corp for Motor Vehicle Repair Mechanical License located at 967 Montello Street, Unit AB, Brockton. Petition of J&B Auto Repair and Frameworks for Motor Vehicle Repair Mechanical License located at 967 Montello Street, Unit C and D, Brockton. Bernardo and Ron Auto Repair for Motor Vehicle Repair Mechanical License located at 967 Montello Street, Unit E. Roland Automotive for Motor Vehicle Repair Mechanical License located at 967 Montello Street, Unit F.
That all? That's that all four. Councilors, I would now entertain a motion. I don't know if any of these licensees here, but Lieutenant Williams and Mr. Cassiri are looking for more information from the landlord. I would entertain a motion to postpone these.
Motion to postpone.
Second.
Motion made and seconded to postpone to the next city council meeting. And if these people are watching, they need to get in touch with their landlord and submit the information to the fire department and the building department. Motion made and seconded to postpone to the next city council meeting. All those in favor? All those opposed? So postponed.
Petition of
Mr. President.
Council Farwell.
Just a point of information on agenda item number 2. Could you inquire of the clerk if that had gone to public safety or was it just postponed to tonight for the hearing and it should go to public safety?
Well, it was just postponed from last week. I was waiting for a motion. Nobody made one to send it there.
Then I'd like to move reconsideration in the hope that it does prevail so that a second motion can be offered to send it to public safety. So the first motion is reconsideration in the hope it prevails.
Okay, so we want to vote on reconsideration and a vote. Yes. So if you want to reconsider it, the vote is yes. So the vote is for reconsideration in the hopes it does prevail. Please call the roll.
Azak.
Yes.
Barnes.
Yes.
Bogart.
Yes.
Food.
Yes.
Pioneering.
Yes.
Farwell.
Yes.
Lally.
Yes.
Monahan.
Yes.
Rodriguez.
Yes.
Studinski.
Yes.
Sullivan.
Yes.
So reconsideration prevails.
Now, Mr. President, I'll move to refer this to public safety.
Second.
Second.
Is that correct? The motion is made and seconded to refer to public safety. All those in favor? All those opposed? The order is referred to public safety. Mr. Thompson, you'll get notification of the public safety subcommittee meeting, which is not scheduled yet, but it will be scheduled the next week or so, and you'll get notification to go there. That subcommittee has some questions. We've been sending all the licenses, all the garage licenses there, so, and automotive repair licenses. Item number 9.
Petition of Pyres Brothers Auto Repair, Inc. for Motor Vehicle Repair Mechanical License located at 50 Meadowbrook Road, Unit 2, Brockton, City Clerk's Office, June 21, 2016. Hearing is signed for September 26, 2016 at 8 p.m. In Council, September 26, 2016, Councilor Fowle, motion to refer to public safety, properly seconded. November 2nd, 2016, favorable with stipulations of hours of operation. And there is a site plan on file.
Questions on the stipulations? All those in favor? All those opposed? Stipulations carry. Question is now on granting as stipulated by hand vote. All those in favor? All those opposed? License is granted.
It says that there is parking plans submitted.
Item number 10.
Classic Auto Repair for Motor Vehicle Repair Mechanical License located at 50 Meadowbrook Road, Unit 3, Brockton. Clerk's Office, June 8, 2016. Hearing assigned October 11, 2016 at 8 p.m. In Council, refer to public safety. Public safety, favorable with stipulations. And there is a parking plan submitted.
Questions on the stipulations? All those in favor? All those opposed? The stipulations are approved. Questions on granting as stipulated by hand vote. All those in favor? All those opposed? The license is granted. Item number 11.
Ordinance amending Chapter 27 of revised ordinances of the City of Brockton, be ordained by the City Council of Brockton as follows. Chapter 27, Zoning, Section 27-4, Designation of Zones, is hereby amended by deleting this section in its entirety and inserting new section 27-35-1I4, Salvage Yard Overlay District, in Council, September 26, 2016. Refer to the Committee on Ordinance and Planning. That report is favorable.
The motion is to pass to a third reading by hand vote. All those in favor? All those opposed? Pass to a third reading.
Ordinance amending Section 2-146 of the revised ordinances of the City of Brockton, Section 2-146, Compensation School Committee Members Elected by Ward, in Council, September 26, 2016. Ready to refer to the Committee on Ordinance. That report is favorable.
Question is on passing to a third reading. All those in favor? All those opposed? Pass to a third reading. Item number 13.
Appointment of Mary Milligan as parking clerk for the City of Brockton, and Council, November 14, 2016. Refer to the Committee on Finance. That report is favorable.
Question is on adoption by a roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Yes.
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 The appointment is confirmed.
Reappointment of Daniel Campbell as a constable in the City of Brockton for a term of 3 years, and Council, November 14, 2016. Referred to the Committee on Finance. That report is favorable.
Question is on confirmation by roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Yes.
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 11 in the affirmative.
The order is adopted. The appointment is confirmed.
Appointment of Jamal Johnson as Special Police Officer for the City of Brockton for a one-year term ending November 2017, and Council November 14, 2016. Refer to the Standing Committee on Finance. That report is favorable.
Question is on confirmation by a roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Yes.
Yes.
Barnes.
Yes.
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 Sullivan.
Yes.
The appointment is confirmed.
Order that the sum of $2 million is appropriated to pay costs of inspecting and rehabilitating 7 miles of the parallel 24-inch transmission mains from Silver Lake Water Treatment Plant to Browns Crossing Pump Station, including the payment of all costs incidental and related thereto. And to meet this appropriation, the Treasurer, with the approval of the Mayor, is authorized to borrow a set amount under the pursuant to Chapter 44 and or Chapter 29C of the General Laws, are pursuant to any other enabling authority, and to issue bonds or notes of the City thereafter. There is a conditional certification on this order.
Questions on passage to a third reading. All those in favor? All those opposed? Pass to a third reading. Item number 17.
An appropriation of $25,000 from unappropriated estimate receipts of the General Fund for fiscal 2017, the Law Department Ordinary Maintenance Services, and Council, November 14, 2016. Refer to the Committee on Finance. That report is favorable.
Questions on adoption by roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Yes.
Barnes.
No.
Beauregard.
Yes.
Cruz.
Yes.
Ioneary.
Yes.
Farwell.
Yes.
Lally.
Yes.
Monahan.
Yes.
Rodriguez.
Yes.
Studinski.
Yes.
Sullivan.
Yes.
The order is adopted.
An appropriation of $367,000 from unappropriate estimate receipts for the General Fund for fiscal 2017 to non-net school spending, and Council, November 14, 2016. Refer to the Standing Committee on Finance. That report is favorable.
Question is on adoption by roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Azak.
Yes.
Barnes.
This is 17?
18.
Oh, 18. Yes.
Beauregard.
Yes.
Cruz.
Yes.
Ioneary.
Yes.
Farwell.
Yes.
Lally.
Yes.
Monahan.
Yes.
Rodriguez.
No.
Studinski.
Yes.
Sullivan.
Yes.
And in the affirmative, one in the negative.
The order is adopted.
An appropriation of $50,000 from unappropriated estimate receipts, fiscal 2017, of the general fund to Assessors Department Ordinary Maintenance Services and Council, November 14, 2016. Refer to Standing Committee on Finance. That report is favorable.
Question is on adoption by a roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Azaff.
Yes.
Barnes.
Yes.
Beauregard.
No.
Cruz.
Yes.
Ioneary.
Yes.
Farwell.
No.
Lally.
Yes.
Monahan.
Yes.
Rodriguez.
Yes.
Stavinsky.
Yes.
Sullivan.
Yes.
9 in the affirmative, 2 in the negative.
The order is adopted.
An appropriation of $20,000 from unappropriate estimate receipts of the general fund for fiscal 2017 to finance department personal services other than overtime and council, November 14, 2016. Refer to the Committee on Finance. That report is favorable.
Question is on adoption by a roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Azaff.
Yes.
Barnes.
Yes.
Beauregard.
Yes.
Cruz.
Yes.
Ioneary.
Yes.
Farwell.
Yes.
Lally.
Yes.
Monahan.
Yes.
Rodriguez.
Yes.
Stavinsky.
Yes.
Sullivan.
Yes.
The order is adopted.
Appropriation of a grant award in the amount of $7,781.52 for the Mass Department of Public Health, Region 5, Mass Association of Health Boards grant, the City of Brockton Board of Health, Mass Association of Health Boards grant fund, and Council, November 14, 2016. Refer to the Committee on Finance. That report is favorable.
Question is on adoption by a roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Azaff.
Nope.
Barnes.
Yes.
Beauregard.
Yes.
Cruz.
Yes.
Ioneary.
Yes.
Farwell.
Yes.
Lally.
Yes.
Monahan.
Yes.
Rodriguez.
Yes.
Stavinsky.
Yes.
Sullivan.
Yes.
The order is adopted.
Appropriation of $102,000 from unappropriated estimate receipts, general fund for fiscal 2017 to the stabilization fund and council, November 14, 2016. Refer to the Committee on Finance. That report is favorable.
Questions on adoption by a roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Azaff.
Yes.
Barnes.
Yes.
Beauregard.
Yes.
Cruz.
Yes.
Ioneary.
Yes.
Farwell.
Yes.
Lally.
Yes.
Monahan.
Yes.
Rodriguez.
Yes.
Stavinsky.
Yes.
Sullivan.
Yes.
The order is adopted.
Appropriation of $635,000 from unappropriate estimate receipts, the general fund for fiscal 2017, the stabilization fund, and council, November 14, 2016. Refer to the Committee on Finance. That report is favorable.
Questions on adoption by roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Yes.
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 Sullivan.
Yes.
The order is adopted.
An appropriation of $50,000 from unappropriated estimate receipts of the general fund for fiscal 2017 to public property capital elevator repair. These funds will be used in order to provide funding in addition to the $115,000 appropriated in the fiscal 2017 budget, as this added funding is necessary to perform the project as estimated. In council, November 14, 2016. Refer to the Committee on Finance. That report is favorable.
Questions on adoption by roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Azaff.
Yes.
Barnes.
Yes.
Beauregard.
Yes.
Cruz.
Yes.
Ioneary.
Yes.
Farwell.
Yes.
Lally.
Yes.
Yes.
Rodriguez.
Yes.
Stavinsky.
Yes.
Sullivan.
Yes.
11 in the affirmative.
The order is adopted.
Appropriation of $73,037.87 from unappropriated estimate receipts of the general fund for fiscal 2017 to fiscal 2016 court judgments, $62,904.30. Roof repair fund, $4,309.632.46. Fiscal 2015 911 grant fund, $3,306.3381.43. Fiscal 2013 911 grant fund, $3,278.6119.68. In order to eliminate various funds appropriation deficits. In council, November 14, 2016. Refer to the Committee on Finance. That report is favorable.
Councilor Rodriguez.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to move to postpone this item until our next council meeting because we were promised to some documentations in terms of the court judgments, and to date we have not received those. So I'd like to make a motion to postpone this.
Second.
Actually, on the motion, Councilor, I would, before I accept it, I'd ask you possibly just to make an amendment and deduct the court judgments. The problem is we will probably be setting the tax rate before our next council meeting. So since the court judgments, can I do that?
You cannot separate out. You can reduce the...
Reduce by 62,904, but not by the line item.
No, you can. You cannot just postpone a portion of it, but you can reduce...
So make an amendment to reduce by 62,904.30, correct? And then the rest of that money, at least then, would still be in the...
How do we get it back on? Because I'm not against the order. I just need those. We just need
those. Actually, it will probably end up being a different order afterwards. That the money will then have to come out of this, out of other receipts, because once we set the tax rate, once we act, and I've received an email today from Mr. Conan that they're probably going to be asking us to have a special meeting in early December to set the tax rate. And since our next meeting will be after that, that would not be, would then have to be a new order, correct?
They have the funds available. Once you set the tax rate, these funds would no longer be
available. So my point is, since the question is only in the court, by postponing it, that we are effectively killing the court judgment part of this. They would then have to come back to us and look for the money out of a different different pot of money.
Well then, Mr. Chairman, Mr. President, then what I'd like to do is submit a motion to reduce the amount by the court judgment and just leave the other amounts in there.
So can you write that out, please? The motion is to...
Second.
...to reduce the order by $62,904.30.
Mr. President, so...
We're going to take a brief recess just so we write this up correctly. Mr. Rodriguez, what Councilor, what we can do is postpone to the next council meeting of any regularly scheduled or special, and we'll be able to take it up the night of the special meeting. So you can make a motion to postpone that. Just word it so that it's the next meeting of the City Council.
Well, then I'd like to move to postpone the agenda item number 25 to our next council meeting.
Second.
Second.
Motion made and seconded to postpone item 25 to the next City Council meeting, regular meeting, or special meeting.
Correct.
All those in favor? All those opposed? Motion carries.
Appropriation of $70,000 from unappropriate estimate receipts of the General Fund, Fiscal 17, to Fire Department Personal Services other overtime, in order to provide added funding for overtime, such as hazardous material team response and training, 911 emergency dispatch training, and training for the Plymouth County Technical Response Team. In Council, November 14, 2016, refer the Committee on Finance. That report is favorable.
Question is on adoption by roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Azar.
Yes.
Barnes.
Yes.
Beauregard.
Yes.
Cruz.
Yes.
Pioneer.
Yes.
Harwell.
Yes.
Lally.
Yes.
Monahan.
Yes.
Rodriguez.
Yes.
Stadinsky.
Yes.
Solomon.
Yes.
11 in the affirmative.
The order is adopted.
Resolved that the City Council authorizes the approval of the proposed housing development incentive program, tax increment exemption agreement for 93 Center Street between the City and Yoma Realty Trust. In Council, November 14, 2016. For the Committee on Finance, that report is favorable.
Questions on adoption by roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Azar.
Yes.
Barnes.
Yes.
Beauregard.
No.
Cruz.
Yes.
Pioneer.
Yes.
Farwell.
Yes.
Lally.
Yes.
Monahan.
Yes.
Rodriguez.
Yes.
Tadinsky.
Yes.
Solomon.
No.
Yes.
The order is adopted.
Resolved the City Council of the City of Brockton respectfully request the honorable members of the city's legislative delegation to file and support legislation which would allow communities with an enrollment of 10,000 students or more, as reported in the prior calendar year, to be allowed to file a preliminary enrollment report on October 1 of each calendar year, and then final enrollment data on March 1 of the following year, so as to assure the proper level of state aid for the support of the school district. In Council, November 14, 2016, for the Committee on Finance, that report is favorable.
Question is on adoption by roll call vote.
Excuse me, Mr. Chairman. I have in my notes, though, I think, didn't we do something with this, waiting for Attorney Gilday? Attorney Gilday had some information that he was going to give us on this. Because I don't have, I have it marked off on mine as it wasn't finished. Am I remembering that incorrectly?
The only thing that Attorney Gilday was part of that is he was somehow accidentally invited to the meeting to speak on this by the auditor's office.
Oh, okay. All right. I thought there was some information we'd asked for on this as well. I'm just looking.
He doesn't know anything about this. He knows everything there is to know about everything else.
Okay.
But
all right. I thought we were supposed to get more information. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for clarifying.
Thank you, but thank you for remembering. Question is on adoption by roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Azak.
Yes.
Barnes.
Yes.
Beauregard.
Yes.
Cruz.
Yes.
Dianetti.
Yes.
Farwell.
Yes.
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 Rodriguez.
Yes.
Kavinsky.
Yes.
Sullivan.
Yes.
The order is adopted.
Resolved that City Council authorize the approval of the proposed housing development incentive program tax increment exemption agreement for 47 Pleasant Street between the City and 47 Pleasant Street Realty Trust. In Council, November 14, 2016. Read and report to the Committee on Finance. That report is favorable.
Questions on adoption by roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Azak.
Yes.
Barnes.
Yes.
Beauregard.
Yes.
Cruz.
Yes.
Dianetti.
Yes.
Farwell.
Yes.
Miley.
Yes.
Monahan.
Yes.
Rodriguez.
Yes.
Stadinsky.
Yes.
Sullivan.
Yes.
11 in the affirmative.
Resolve is adopted.
Resolve to invite Sergeant Brenda Perez and the recently hired crime analyst to present their findings and progress on the study that began in April 2016 for the City of Brockton. This presentation should include locations of high crime rates, communications with other law enforcement agencies, other programs that have come to fruition based on these findings, and collaborations and future plans with the use of this data. The hope of this presentation is to provide the City Council and the public with a better understanding of the process of preventing and lowering crime throughout the city and make it for a safer community for residents and businesses alike. In Council, November 14, 2016. Ready to refer to the Committee on Finance. That report is favorable.
Question is on adoption by a roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Azak.
Yes.
Barnes.
Yes.
Beauregard.
Yes.
Cruz.
Yes.
Dianetti.
Yes.
Powell.
Yes.
Lally.
Yes.
Monahan.
Yes.
Rodriguez.
Yes.
Stadinsky.
Yes.
Sullivan.
Yes.
11 in the affirmative.
The order is adopted.
Resolved that the Mayor, Police Chief, Fire Chief, City Solicitor, Board of Health Director, and other relative city employees appear before the Finance Committee to discuss the recent action taken by the city to vacate 10th City on privately owned property. In Council, July 25th, 2016. Reading for the Committee on Finance. That report is favorable.
Question is on adoption by roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Yes.
Barnes.
No.
Beauregard.
Yes.
Cruz.
Yes.
Dianetti.
Yes.
Farwell.
Yes.
Yes.
Monahan.
Yes.
Rodriguez.
No.
Yes.
Sullivan.
No.
The resolve is adopted.
Resolved to have the Brockton Board of Assessors Chairman, John P. O'Donnell, our designee to inform City Council of the process and steps taken for assessing the value of Brockton homes. In Council, June 27, 2016. Refer the Committee on Finance. That report is favorable.
Questions on adoption by a roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Azak.
Yes.
Barnes.
No.
Beauregard.
No.
Cruz.
Yes.
Dianetti.
Yes.
Farwell.
Yes.
Lally.
Yes.
Monahan.
Yes.
Rodriguez.
Yes.
Stadinsky.
Yes.
Sullivan.
Yes.
9 in the affirmative, 2 in the negative.
The order is adopted.
Resolved to invite Jesse Pack, coordinator of the Cope Center, to discuss the policy practices of the clean syringe distribution, a background on the history of other services you provide, the safeguards in place with the programs or the plans for future programs regarding substance abuse. And Council, October 24, 2016. For the Committee on Finance, that report is favorable.
Question is on adoption by roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Yes.
No.
No.
Cruz.
Yes.
Dianetti.
Yes.
Farwell.
Yes.
Lally.
No.
Monahan.
Yes.
Rodriguez.
No.
Stadinsky.
Yes.
Sullivan.
Yes. On the motion, I mean, on the vote, I just had a point of information, Mr. President, if I could.
Point of information?
I just wanted to let everybody know that I spoke to a couple different law enforcement agents that serve public safety personnel that serve the city of Brockton, and they wanted to just commend this body for the questions that were asked to Mr. Simonelli. And these gentlemen also confirmed to me that indeed most of the people that they deal with are not originally from the city of Brockton. So kudos to my counselors that brought that up. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Order is adopted.
Resolved to invite Fire Chief to appear before the committee of this council to review the expenditures from the Fire Department budget and to bring with him any and all documents related to such expenditure, including any supporting contract. And Council, November 14, 2016, for the Committee on Finance. That report is favorable.
Questions on adoption by a roll call vote. Will the clerk please call the roll?
No.
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 Yes.
No.
Marla.
No.
Lally.
Yes.
Monahan.
Yes.
Rodriguez.
Yes.
Studinski.
Yes.
Sullivan.
Yes.
Six in the affirmative, five in the negative.
Resolve is adopted.
Resolve that the mayor be invited to appear before a committee of this council to review the expenditures for payment, tuition, and other fees for the mayor at Massasoit Community College from the city budget, and to bring with him any and all documents related to such expenditures, including any supporting authorization for such expenditure. In council, November 14, 2016, ready to refer to the Standing Committee on Finance. That report is favorable.
Mr. President.
Councilor Ranieri.
Mr. President, if I might, because we have a typo error here indicating just how this left the Finance Committee meeting last week. It was a 7-4 vote, and I was one of the nays. And what we have here this evening is just mentioning Councilor Beauregard, Fowler, and Sullivan is voting negative. It's incorrect to what we have with the Finance meeting. I just want to make sure that it's taken care of. Thank you.
Question is, Councilor Farwell.
Yes, Mr. President, I'm going to vote in favor of this resolve, but I wanted to take a couple of minutes tonight to just mention that, you know, it's easy to come in here and vote for appropriations and to confirm people to positions. It's very hard to hold people we know accountable. It's very hard to ask tough questions. The Accounts Committee, when it reviewed certain documents, felt it important to advance those documents to this body. And I feel very badly that, unfortunately, some of the comments at our last meeting degenerated down into suggestions that somehow people were against a certain group, or that there was hatred towards a certain group. And I would just say to my colleagues, I've been with all of you now for the last 11 months. I don't know of a single person in here whom I think is prejudiced. I don't know of anyone in here who doesn't come in and try to make the best possible decision on policy decisions and appropriations. But I think it's very important that as we do conduct our business and as we do hold people accountable and we ask tough questions, that we make sure that we don't try to steer the debate into something that it isn't. I can tell you now that I've known Councilor Ianeri for 35 years. If he were the mayor and I saw the same documents and I saw the same issues present themselves, I'd haul him before the council and hold him accountable. So it has nothing to do with personalities. It has nothing to do with the different groups that we're very privileged to have in this city, but it has everything to do with what we're supposed to do, and that's be a check and balance to protect the interests of our residents and to hold people accountable. So going forward, I look to working with all of you, and I hope that we'll just make sure that we don't try to spin something into something it isn't. And with that, I thank you, Mr. President.
Mr. President.
Councilor Sullivan.
I also just wanted to, first of all, thank the five members that serve on the Accounts Committee. But I do want to remind all the councilors that all 11 of us voted for a resolve that I sponsored. It was really a catalyst for this. It was to ask about credit card usage in the city of Brockton. We then forwarded that, after I spoke with Mr. Ianeri, the chair, to accounts. So I echo the sentiments of my colleague. This isn't a personal attack, but it's reviewing expenses that we're charged to look at and analyze. So again, thank you to the five that sit on that, and I hope that the next legislative session will continue that practice. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. And just before we take the vote, just a reminder to the public that even though the enterprise may report it this way, a resolve is not us approving the payments. This was a resolve is strictly the opinion of the council. and it is not approving any payments or disapproving any payments. That is not what we get to do at that point. So just to explain what a resolve is. Question is on adoption by roll call vote. Will clerk, please call the roll.
Azak.
Yes.
Barnes.
Yes.
Beauregard.
No.
Cruz.
Yes.
Ioneary.
No.
Farwell.
Yes.
Lally.
Yes.
Monahan.
No.
Rodriguez.
Yes.
Studinski.
Yes.
Sullivan.
No.
The resolve is adopted.
Mr. Chairman, I have a question.
Councilor Barnes.
Again, I'm going back to my notes. Please feel free to correct me if I'm wrong. But number 31, the resolve about Tent City, I have it here. It was 21 last week, and we postponed it because none of the people were here.
No, we took a motion to, because we had received the information during the day in an email form that the invoice was paid by the train company.
Okay, was, Chairman, that, if I could, I filed that resolve. We had postponed the previous meeting because we only had an oral representation from Mr. Riley that indeed it had been paid.
And you received
it. Had been paid.
And
so I postponed it for proof of written documentation, which we received the PDF form.
Okay, yeah. I'm just double checking. Thank,
thank you.
Thank you. Item number 36.
Resolved, if the City Council and agent, after careful analysis and by vote of its members, determines the Shaw Center is the most appropriate and advantageous location for expansion of programs and services, the City Council expresses its support for that relocation and urges the mayor to take whatever actions may be necessary to support and assist this proposal.
Refer to Finance.
Resolve the Public Safety Committee, the City Council, shall meet and review the provisions of the new law, review current zoning, business regulations, and public safety issues with appropriate department heads, hold a public hearing at discretion of the committee, and report back to the full council no later than the first regular meeting in March 2017 with recommendations of proposed ordinance changes to protect the interests of our residents.
Refer to Finance. Councilors, any other business? Councilor Farwell.
Yes, just a moment of personal privilege, if I might. This Thursday, December 1st, from 6:30 until 8 at the West Middle School, the councilors at large will hold their fourth and final meeting of this calendar year. The first half of the meeting will feature a presentation from Daniel Zivkovich, who was the Executive Director of the Municipal Police Training Council. I think those who are interested in how the police operate and the level of training that we offer to our police officers when they are first selected and during in-service times will be very informative and I hope reassuring. I think the reason we have fewer incidents in this state as we have nationwide is because of that training. And the second personal privilege is actually directed towards the chair. I know we're going to have a meeting to set the tax rate. And in my view, that's an opportunity for us to very carefully do what we can to help not only the businesses, but also the residents. And I know a lot of residents last year got a big surprise with their tax bill. So I would like to ask the chairman if he would request that the auditors, that the assessor's office, when they make their presentation, I'd like to know the different factors and what the cost would be per thousand up or down.
We so get that every year. That
we do, and the cost per thousand?
Yes.
So that we can find out exactly what the impact will be?
Correct.
All right, thank you.
On that,
Councilor Monahan.
Just point of the thing that happened last year was that the valuations of the multifamilies went up. That's where that jacked it up, so that's where that came into play. Also, Mr. President, I'd like to make a motion for reconsideration on number 17, as some information has come from the employees, and they have some concerns on that appropriation. And so I don't know if any...
When did you receive that information?
Second.
You realize we have an ordinance against outside... Motion made and seconded to take reconsideration on item number 17.
25,000.
I already voted no on that.
Question. Motion is made and seconded for reconsideration on number 17. All those in favor of reconsideration?
I'd like to send it back. The whole thing is to bring this back to finance.
Okay.
Okay, that's on the law department?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Mr. Chairman,
motion made, seconded for reconsideration.
If I might, personal privilege.
On the motion.
I don't mind making a vote one way or the other on this. I'd like to know what the new evidence is. Is there a reason to do something like that? If we could hear whoever has it.
When the, from what I understand is that third party, which we talked about the last time, that we actually already have a third party working with the law department on this. So there was already a third party working, and that's what this money, that the appropriation is for, is for a third party. And it's, I think it's a different, I'd just like to get some clarification on that. Okay. Because there is already a third party involved with the workman's comp and checking on the employees and what have you. So I just want to get a clarification on that, where we already have a third party working with the law department.
Thank you, Councilor. Thank you, Mr. President.
Motion made and seconded for reconsideration. All those in favor of reconsideration? All those opposed? Reconsideration passes. Question is now on, and now you'd like to make a motion?
Let's make a motion that it go to the next finance meeting. Okay. We postpone the next finance meeting.
Second. Motion made and seconded to send back to finance. All those in favor?
Sure.
Hold your hands up, please. All those opposed? Refer back to finance. 17 will be referred to finance. And councilors, just so you know, I did receive notification. This is not official, but we may be receiving a request from the mayor's office for a special meeting, which will probably be on the 5th of December to set the tax rate, but that is not official yet.
1 week from tonight.
It'll be 1 week from tonight, correct. Councilor Beauregard.
Yes, Mr. President, if I could have a moment of personal privilege.
You may.
Okay, thank you. I just want to, commend the individuals. This is the holiday season, and there were plenty of people that were part of the holiday parade at 30 years, the last one in downtown Brockton, and we just want to commend and thank these people, and we're very lucky this year. It was absolutely gorgeous out. And all the other people that came out on Thanksgiving and volunteered to help feed individuals and participate in helping them, individuals alone, have a great Thanksgiving. And as usual, that is part of our city's mindset to be champions to others. And as the holiday season continues, we just want to recognize these individuals and thank them.
Thank you very much.
Mr. President.
Councilor Sullivan.
If you call a special meeting on Monday night, would you have any, 7 o'clock will be finance, would you have any idea what time you would call that?
I'll have to look into it. I don't know that yet. I just received that notification today, and it may not be able to happen, but
okay.
The reason Mr. Conan's email to me is there are time factors involved with paperwork that the city has to finish then to get to the Department of Revenue to then get approved by the Department of Revenue so that tax bills, which have to go up by the 12/31 by law, can be done.
Okay.
So there are some time constraints, and some of those items that got referred to finance could become problematic if we can't act before then. So we'll have to look at that.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. And just I'm not sure if the new councilors were ever informed of this. We do have an ordinance that affects this council against receiving phone calls and texts during the meeting. So just something Councilor Monahan put together years ago, which was very good. Mm-hmm. So just wanted to make sure everybody knew that. Hope everybody had a good Thanksgiving. We'll see you next week. We're adjourned.